Congrats on creating an interface and a table. Top tier talent. I draft you as my fourth or fifth pick for the automation team. Now, you still may be wondering when to use what and how it all works together. Let me just tell you, imagine you're an outdoor retail shop. You've got a whole process for taking orders, fulfilling them, and sending customer emails. There are a lot of moving pieces. You need things to be quick and reliable so that you can focus on delivering to customers. So the best way to use interfaces and tables is to consolidate all those orders into one single source of truth in Zapier tables. You also need a quick and easy way to get those orders into the table in the first place. So you'd use interfaces to build out a quick form. So when all this is in Zapier, you've got a easy drag and drop form builder with interfaces where customers can visit the form page, or you can embed this in your website. You keep all the orders in a reliable Zapier table that gives you visibility into how each field is connected to a process. And then, of course, you have those workflows that power the whole thing. Zaps, they'll shift and move your data among all the apps that you're using. So with Zapier, you get to build and experiment easily and quickly all in one place. So if you haven't yet, go ahead, create a form and interfaces. You'll have an option to connect a Zapier table. Go ahead and do that. And that's just the start. From there, fill out the form, see how the data flows into Zapier tables, and then you can add the process in through Zaps. You can add a button into the table to send an email or fulfill an order. With all these pieces in one place, you're gonna be able to move quickly in no time.